like the voice acting is so stoic and matter of fact, you know, that it's hard to kind of read the way it sounds.
Marines are getting hammered. Take out the guns on the pier.
First they tell me to concentrate on the ground, and then they say they need help with the fighters. Look for the bombers. Save these Marines. Look for the bombers. We'll concentrate on this other stuff. Like, yeah, thanks. And then all of a sudden they're like, we need help with the fighters. Really? I'm looking for bombers right now. Anyway. Hey, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, whatever. We're moving forward on this attack on the Tawara. Tawawa Aloy Island or something. A Tawara Atoll Island. And remember last episode.
I just made me a chap.
Good for you, dude. Remember last episode. Took a lot of pictures of the island just to get the idea, and they found out that by looking at the pictures that all of the defense is facing in one direction. There's a big opening on the back end, so we put the Marines on the back end, and it's my job as the pilot to help protect the Marines as they go slaughter things. I take out the anti-aircraft and the ground guns, and yeah, that's pretty much it. The other people were supposed to get the planes and handle all the stuff in the air, and they're not really doing it. So, yep.
We're no longer taking fire. Second wave of troops getting ready to move in.
Hey, we could use some help with these fighters.
Where is that air cover?
Attack my target.
Okay, boss. I'll take the fighters.
Hey, we need air support!
Just told you, just won't die!
Fighter destroyed!
My target.
Roger. Bomber on my target. Bomber flame. He's going down.
Attack my target.
Bomber's targeted. Moving to engage. Bomber down.
My target.
We're going after the bombers. Bomber going down.
Tom Stewart was lucky. Too lucky. His engine trouble was too convenient. He was back on the carrier safe in his bunk while we were fighting for our lives against the 13th Squadron. The other pilots were furious. They wanted his blood. They found Stewart in his bunk. They pulled him out, screaming traitor, Jap lover, and worse. Callahan and I could barely stop them from stringing him up right there. We got him out of there and back to Callahan's room. Tom pleaded with us. He promised he wasn't a traitor, that he hadn't sold us out to the Japs. I wanted to believe him, but there was part of me that wasn't sure. But the other guys, they wouldn't fly with him anymore. And even if he did fly with us again, he'd be likely to get a tail full of U.S.-issue bullets. Callahan grounded him and took his wings away. He said it was for Stewart's own safety, but I think it was for all our sakes. Earlier, during the recon mission, I'd taken out an ace called Taiki Hasegawa from the 13th. I'd fought three of their top guys, but I still hadn't had a chance to fly against Shunagawa. The Japanese commander at Betio Island had promised it would take 1 million men 100 years to take Tarawa. Rear Admiral Shibasaki, the commander there, had spent years fortifying the island. He'd put in new layered defenses that gave mutual support. When we did land there, after just a few hours of bombing, our Marines were cut to pieces by the Japs. The first wave suffered almost total casualties. Eventually, we took the island, but not before we lost 1,500 men. The Japs lost over 3 times that many. Tarawa was a learning experience for us, a lesson in how not to take an island from the Japanese. The rest of 43 was quiet. We all pulled our fleets back for repairs and refitting. Back home, though, things weren't quiet. Our factories were running at full speed. Back then, we churned out 7,000 planes a month, compared to just 1,500 that the Japanese could produce. It wasn't just planes, though. Our shipyards were also running full tilt. Since the start of the war, we'd produced 500 destroyers and escorts. With a shortage of raw materials, the Japs could barely manage 30.
We have just received an urgent radio message from our top agent, codenamed Usurper. After infiltrating a secret Japanese airbase and retrieving vital war plans, Usurper escaped by stealing a Japanese seaplane Zero called Roof. Unfortunately, his aircraft took several hits and he has made a forced landing. The Japanese will be looking for him too. You are to take a PBY Catalina and rescue him. We can guide you into the area of Usurper's last transmission. Usurper will fire a red flare to guide you to his exact location. Pick him up and return to base. His information could save many lives, Lieutenant.
Okay, Lieutenant. Our last radio contact with Usurper was from bearing 305. Suggest you climb the search altitude and proceed north-northeast.
No problem, Hornet. Let me just ease this big mama off the water. Everyone keep their eyes peeled. I want to hear about it immediately if you spot anything.
Boss, either we gotta pick off the Japs from a distance or run like hell. I wouldn't want to be dogfighting in this old sow.
Sir, I can see a flare.
We'll need to take those cruisers out before we can pick them up, and fast.
Thank you.
to keep their eyes peeled. I want to hear about it immediately if you spot anything.
Boss, either we gotta pick off the Japs from a distance or run like hell. I wouldn't want to be dogfighting in this old sow.
Sir, I can see a flare.
We'll need to take those cruisers out before we can pick them up, and fast.
Man, that guy was right, man. This thing is a slow old sow. I don't know why we couldn't have just blown by these stupid things. I mean, by blown by, I meant slowly jog by. Look at this, man. Why would you put those little teeny propellers on that big ass thing? It's basically a glider. Glider with two teeny engines on it. Sure, it's a lot bigger, but... yeesh.
Torpedo dropped!
This is Usurper. Any U.S. units in the area? I need assistance urgently. Japanese cruiser, bearing down fast on my location.
It's a Japanese carrier sub!
Look at the size of the monster. Come on, we have to get the hell out of here.
Clock, high!
Behind us!
Well, looks like that information was more important than I thought. Flying if I've ever seen it. I'll be telling your CO about this.
Had a tough flight, Lieutenant. Are you okay to land?
Oh, there are a lot of holes, but this big mama's still watertight. We'll be able to keep her floating for a while yet.
Put her down next to the cruisers and we'll get one of them to winch you aboard for repairs.
Thanks for the little home, Lieutenant Crowe. You really saved my bacon today.
Finally! That took forever. If I had a faster plane, I feel pretty confident I could pick him up pretty quickly. But whatever.